Dear students of class 8, we are going to study chapter number 4. This is the second part. In the first part, we have studied about the causes of the French Revolution. What were the causes of the French Revolution? Students, if you do not remember, I would like to revise it for you. Unequal social order means the rights were not given equally among the people. There were three different states: the first state, the second state, and the third state. The first state and the second states enjoyed all the privileges, means they were having the birth rights. And the third class, which was around 96% of the people around, and they did not have much rights or many rights for them. So rise of middle class played also important role in French Revolution. Philosophers and revolutionary ideas played an important role in French Revolution. And autocratic monarchy means a king who does not listen to anyone, and he does whatever he want, is known as the autocratic monarchy. And corrupt administration, and the administration was also very corrupt in France. So the people revolted against all these. Impact of the American Revolution. What was the impact of the American Revolution in French Revolution? So let me tell you, the French Revolution took place between 1789 to 1799, and the American Revolution took place between 1765 to 1783. So students, French army helped the American to gain the freedom and independence from British rule, greatly inspired the French people to revolt against the absolute monarchy. So when the army reached to America and when they fought for the Americans, they gained the freedom from the British colonial rule. They were very much inspired by this victory. Many French military generals had fought in the American Revolution, means many French generals, military generals, fought for the American Revolution. They returned home with revolutionary ideas and experiences and inspired people to fight for their rights. The Declaration of Independence, which advocated rights of individuals to liberty and equality, furthered French people's aspirations towards a democratic setup. So when the military generals came to their own country, they inspired people. The experiences they got during the American Revolution, with those experiences, they inspired people to fight for their rights. And the Declaration of Independence, the Declaration of Independence took place in America, which advocated rights of individuals to liberty and equality, further French people aspirations towards a democratic setup. And through this, which was declared in America, the French people got inspired by that declaration, and they also wanted to have the setup in their own country. The same kind of setup means what the people wanted to have. People wanted to have liberty and equality in their own country that they did not have till now. Why they did not have till now? Because the first state, the clergy class, and the noble class, means the second state, they enjoyed all the rights. And the third state, means the middle class and the 96% of people, that did not have the equality and liberty in their own country. So they got inspired by the revolutionary ideas, which was shared by the military generals to them. Declaration of the National Assembly. and an important declaration took place. That was the declaration of National Assembly in May 1789. The King Louis 16 called a meeting of state generals to discuss the financial problems that France was facing. So as France helped Americans in gaining the independence, the France also put lot of money in that war, and France started struggling in finance, and they got financial problems. At this meeting, the third state did not approve of the voting pattern of each state having one vote. This meant that they could always be outvoted by the first and the second state, who were much less in number. They wanted the vote to be based on the number of members. So what was the planning? When the state general meeting was called, there were around 300 people from the first state, and there were 300 people from the second state, and the 600 people were there, means 600 leaders of the third state reached to the state general meeting. So what was announced by the king? The king declared that each state, means first, second and third state, will have the right to cast only one vote. So it will be problem for the third state, because if the first and second state will want something to be done, then third state will not have value if they vote against it. So third state realized that this idea will not change the condition of the France. On 17 June 1789, members of the third state, in a revolutionary move, declared themselves as a national assembly for the sake of their representation, thus marking the beginning of the revolution. So there were 600 people around in the third state. Okay, means 300 people, means 600 people, those who were the representative of the third state, they declared themselves the National Assembly. They had an intention to rule their own country through their group, means through their through a National Assembly. The demands of the third state remained unrecognized by the monarchy, leading to the closing of the session. So what happened? The monarchy did not accept the National Assembly in the beginning, but later on what happened? The nobles suggested the king, that King Louis was suggested that if you will not accept the National Assembly, then it will be difficult for you to rule France, because in the third state there are 96%, means most of the people are there in the third state. On 20 June 1789, members of the third state met at a tennis court and took the oath to not disperse until they framed a new constitution for the France. So what happened? When the decision was not made in the state general meeting, then they reached to a tennis court. You know, it was a place where tennis used to be played by the people. So it was a peaceful place. So they decided to reach there, and they decided to take an oath. So as you can see in the picture, here it is given in the first picture, students. As you can see, the people taking oath, and this is tennis court. This tennis court, as you can see, that the hands of the people are raising. When do we raise our hand? When we take an oath. So they took an oath in the tennis court, and it was known as tennis court oath. The king gave in and promised a degree of representative government, and the king felt himself defeated, means he lost his control over the people, and promised a degree of representative government, and he promised that yes, the third state will also be the part of the government. But it was not satisfactory for the people, and outbreak of the French Revolution took place. On 14 July 1789, many members of the third state attacked Bastille, the state prison for political prisoners. It is a prison where the people were kept in a prison, and you know, who are the people? Those who did not follow the orders of the King Louis XVI, means they were against the King Louis. The prison was a symbol of power and operation of Ancienism. So Ancienism, you will hear again and again, Ancienism was a social and political order, or social and political system in France during the 18th century is known as Ancienism, and they opposed this Ancienism. The prisoners opposed the Ancienism. The prisoners of Bastille were released and they joined the revolutionaries, and as they were released, they were very happy and they wanted to be very honest with the with the people, those who helped them release from there. The storming of Bastille symbolized the victory of the French people over their monarchy and marked the beginning of the French Revolution. So they became the part of the revolution, and they revolted against the monarchy system, or they came against the King Louis XVI. Following the storming of Bastille, the representative of the third state who declared themselves as the National Assembly took control of the administration of France. And as the leaders of the third state, they recognized themselves as a National Assembly. They took the control of the administration of France. The National Assembly adopted the Declaration of Rights of Man and Citizens on 26th August 1789. The Declaration of Human and Civil Rights were the main principles of the new constitution, which with rational thinking at its foundation. By 1791, a new constitution was adopted, and a constitutional monarchy was set up in France. So as we see the constitutional monarchy in England, so you know, the same kind of constitutional monarchy was tried to set up, whether you know, king was also given the role in the administration. And as the declaration of the right of the man and citizen was taken place, this kind of constitutional monarchy was set up in France. And what happened after that? What happened in 1792? The Tuileries. It is a royal residence in Paris where the king lived. The King Louis lived with her queen, attacked by the Persian mob, and led to the capture of King Louis XVI and Marie Antoinette. King Louis XVI and Marie Antoinette, who were subsequently executed in 1793. And the Persian mob captured the king, King Louis XVI and Marie Antoinette, and killed them. This marked the end of the constitutional monarchy and the emergence of France as the democratic republic. And democratic republic took place after the death of King Louis XVI and Marie Antoinette. And people had the right to vote, and they got their right to be happy in their life. So what was the impact of the French Revolution, that we will do in the next video. Thank you very much. If you have any problem in the video, you may ask me on the group. I will answer your question. This is a very, very interesting chapter. If you'll try to understand it, you will have a good idea about the French Revolution. Thank you so much, children. Have a nice day.